salvage arts and this place right here on Bud. It's wonderful. Everyone that works there is very kind. Has a bottled water dispenser. And the napkins are spectacular. The napkins are hard fabric. We're about to go into this gallery. I don't know the protocol as far as if it's a bad place to go. But I came to an open mic here a week ago, and it was canceled. So this is me making up for it as far as I'm concerned. I'll try not to. Across this giant fucking bridge. I go to South Station, walk towards the child with the big box, with the big boom box. Just keep walking straight in that direction. Past the Federal Reserve Building. There's Our Lady of Good Voyage Church right over there. Bon Voyage. Right when you get to the end of it, right here, you go down there. Another encore song. It's right across from you. Marking the crowd. I remember going there. Yeah. It's kind of weird, I guess. I'll try to jump. Let's just see. I don't want to creep anyone out there.
Disappeared after the ribbon on the maze. So I was chair, and then I was I taught at Brigham State for 31 years. I didn't think my 62nd semester would wind up on Zoom, but it did, and I planned to leave anyway, and it was the perfect time to leave. But actually, my day job there, I was in the communication arts department. Most of our work was either theoretical or digital. And so what I want to do in my art, what I've been doing for 30 years, actually the first piece I made on the lathe was for my daughter, Rattle, when she was born 33. But I always found, so my day job was theoretical and digital, and I wanted to do the opposite of that. Actually, I gave a talk and told somebody this story already. I repeat myself right now. Anyway, I gave a talk at the university actually called Getting Physical, Why This Media Professor Loves His Chainsaw. I don't really love it, but I respect it, and I use it, and so I make physical things. Primarily in wood, and again, sort of like Maddie salvaging scraps from the scrapyard. All of this wood came from most 95% of wood in the last 20 years came from a tree service up in Gilbert, where they put stuff aside for us. It's either so we save it from turning it into vulture or firewood, and they put good stuff aside, so it's just a wonderful place. Plus, the wood's free, it's really amazing. Anyway, so, and also I said my thumbnail statement is that I've always been interested in classical forms, the ancient, the so-called primitive, and the strange. So a lot of these are parts of from a series and so on, but most of them are turned originally on the lathe. Most people think they make baseball bats or balusters. I never do that kind of stuff. It's called fiddle work, do these kinds of things. I call it inefficiency in the pursuit of the unnecessary. But it's still fun. So anyway, I really appreciate the people coming here. Again, it's a joy to make this stuff, and it's a joy to be with people who also make stuff. And we're not going to look at the stuff we make.
Thank you.
Barbie dolls, come on.
Well, the wood stuff is mine, the Barbies are an outlier. By the way, I never liked Barbie dolls. That's actually related. It's called ossuary Barbie, which are ossuaries of container for homes. Yes. But ossuaries are not biodegradable, so it's silly to even think of those terms. But I thought of it as a homage as the so-called bone churches of Eastern Europe, where some places the entire surfaces are covered with human skulls. There's one at Sedlec Church in the Czech Republic, has a chandelier made from every bone in the human body. It's to remind us that life is sweet. But anyway, by the way, I never liked Barbie, but some of those aren't technically Barbie. So 15 years we collect them on eBay, and appropriately enough, today is ostensibly Barbie's 64th birthday. Thank you. 18 years and stuff out of California, so I was ready to go along with the time and simply go live and all that. It really doesn't matter, really, now it's called 3456, it's about 3,456 places. I think that kind of is perfectly spaced. No, that's about a Barbie doll. The Barbie herself.
The thing is, like, with these openings and whatnot, they always have booze, you know? And they always want you to drink booze. Like, I went to one at Massar, which is like a school, so it was weird that they gave me two free drinks. I didn't inquire, like, such a cheese, you know, for like a really good drink, you need four tickets or something like that. But, I mean, like, they had food, like, they had giant fucking hunk of cheese, too. Looks like brie, like, magical brie. Jelly and jam. Cocaine and bananas. I'm sure if I try to attend enough, I'll find one and there's a platter of cocaine and bananas. It's pretty old. It was mostly like an older crowd. No one asked me for the camera, though, so that's good. I have to ask about this open mic, what the deal with that is. I have to find it in the head. I have to find the primary head of the Hydra. This would be fun. Anyway, this is creepy. Creepy. That's it.